Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand.
Hey everybody. In this video, I want to talk about saving default settings in ZoomText. So when we first install ZoomText, it's the default configuration is 2x magnification. The zoom window is set to full. Our pointer enhancements is turned on to a yellow, large yellow pointer. Cursor enhancements are on to a blue wedge, and then the red rectangle focus indicator is turned on. And then under the reader tab, keyboard enhancements are on. Echo is set to words, and then the voice is on. I have it disabled at the moment so it doesn't interrupt me while I'm speaking. But so that is the default configuration of ZoomText. So the first thing we do when we run ZoomText is we start modifying this configuration to better fit us, what we need personally. So I may need, with my condition, maybe I need 3x, and maybe I prefer giant green pointer rather than the large yellow, and maybe I don't want cursor enhancements on or focus enhancements on, so I just clicked those buttons on the ZoomText interface to disable them. So once we have our configuration the way we want it, we need to save these, okay? So there's a couple ways to do this. One way is to click on the ZoomText menu and to come down to configurations and save as default. So if I click on save as default, I'm prompted, are you sure you want to save the current settings as your default settings? I'm going to click yes. So now these are my default settings. So when I close ZoomText and restart ZoomText or reboot the computer, ZoomText is going to open up with 3x magnification with a large green pointer, and voice is going to be disabled. Now, one thing we've probably all experienced is if, say we make a change here, say we prefer 3.5x or 4. If we don't save these, if we close ZoomText or reboot the computer, the next time we start up, it's going to be back at the 3 in this case, because I didn't save the settings once I changed them. I want to show you a setting in preferences. I'm going to go to ZoomText menu, click on preferences, and then program. This setting here called under exit settings, there's a checkbox that says save ZoomText settings automatically when exiting. I really recommend you check this box. This way, whenever you close ZoomText, you don't have to worry about forgetting about saving your settings. You can do what you need to do while you're on using ZoomText. And if you're at 2x magnification and you close ZoomText, the next time you open up, it's going to be back at those settings, 2x magnification. So if we check this box and then we click OK, that will prevent us from having to always go to configuration, save as default, if we make changes to the configuration or default configuration. So I wanted to point that out. The other thing to point out under configurations real quick, say we're playing around with our settings. I'm going to turn on color, and I'm going to go to cursor and turn on, you know, green circle and, you know, bump up magnification. Say we got to a point where it's like, I really want to just go back to what I had before, go back to my default. What you can do, instead of going through each of these settings and turning things off and on, you can go to the ZoomText menu, go to configurations, and then go to open default. And if we click open default, it loads the default configuration that we saved, which is 3x, large green pointer, color enhancements are off. So now the other thing to point out under configurations, one other thing, is we have restore factory default. And so if we ever want to get back to the original settings, say say we just want to go back and start from scratch, you can always go in here, click ZoomText configurations, restore factory default. And when I do that, I'm prompted, are you sure you want to restore the original ZoomText default settings? I'm going to click yes. And here we are, we're back to 2x, yellow pointer, speech should be on.
Keyboard.
Yep.
Zoom level 2.
There we go. And if I do that, I do want to remember to go, I'm going to disable speech, alt caps enter.
Voice disabled.
I want to remember to go back into ZoomText preferences program and go check my save ZoomText settings automatically when exiting, because that would be undone by loading the factory default settings. So we save that and we click that and we click OK. And now we're back to where we can make changes, and then we close ZoomText, save our changes will be saved automatically. So another thing under the ZoomText menu that I want to demonstrate is our application settings. These can come in really, really handy. Let's say that in most of my applications that I work with, I don't need color enhancements. I'm fine with this, you know, with 3x magnification and the large yellow pointer. And let's say I normally don't use the cursor enhancements, and I normally have speech off. I don't need that. Let's say these are my default settings. I'm going to go ahead and just save that real quick. Save as default. So let's say that these are my default settings. But when I use, say, Word, say with my visual condition, I find it easier to read items in Word with color enhancements on. I just press caps lock C, as in Charlie, to turn on color enhancements. In fact, I'm going to press caps control U to bring up the ZoomText interface. So let's say that in Word, I prefer color enhancements on. I want cursor enhancements on when I'm in Word, and I also want my speech, my voice to be
enabled.
But I only want this to be on when I'm in Word, because I don't need it in other applications. So I've made the changes, and there's my cursor enhancement. So I want to save these. So there's a couple things I can do. I can hit Control Caps Lock S. And this says save application settings. You want to save application settings for Microsoft Word. I'm going to click yes. The other way I can do that is if I hit, again, Control Caps U.
Zoom text.
I'm going to go to
menu.
Zoom text.
Application settings
and then save application settings. That's the same as doing Control Caps S. So what that
setting, Zoom text.
What that does, now that we've set the application setting, or we've saved the application settings for Word, my default settings are still what they were. Color enhancements were off. My cursor enhancements were off, and speech was off. So if I go to, say, the desktop, let's go to Chrome.
Freedom Scientific, high quality video magnifiers.
There we go. So now that I'm in Chrome, my default settings kicked in because I don't have application settings specific to Chrome. But if I alt tab back to Word, when focus lands in Word, there we go. Color enhances are turned on automatically. Speech is back on.
Manhattan.
And there's my cursor, my Blue Edge cursor enhancements.
Manhattan.
So let's demonstrate that again. Let me switch to
task switching. Zoom text test document. Freedom Scientific.
Chrome.
High quality video.
So I switch to Chrome. I'm out of Word, so my default settings are loaded. So there's our application settings. I'm gonna click back in Word here. Bring focus, and there we go. Application settings are loaded for Word. So if I want to change these application settings, you know, I can bring up Caps Lock Control U.
Zoom text
interface, and I can modify my settings.
Four.
Say I want 4x instead. I can hit Caps Lock Control S,
save
and save the settings for Word. Again,
Zoom text magnifier reader.
And if I want Zoom to, I'm going to turn speech off.
Voice disabled.
If I want to just get rid of these application settings, I can go to application settings under the Zoom text menu. I can click manage application settings. And I can disable it by just checking the checkbox next to Word. These are the only application settings I have. I can just disable it and say okay. And that turns it off. So now it's just using my default configuration. The keystroke for manage application settings is control caps M as in mic. There you go. So I can enable it. If I just want to delete it entirely, I can select it and click the delete selected option. And I'm prompted, I'm not sure I want to delete the application settings for Word. And I'll say no. No, cancel. So those are just a few different things under the Zoom text menu that that are important to know. I hope you all have a good day.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.